The role of the guitar in the Afrobeat style is to hold down a solid recurring groove that I would describe as definitely funky and most often harmonized in the minor key. There are multiple guitar players in the Afrobeat style, generally at least two or three, and each player holds down their part with equal significance, playing polyrhythmically using single note lines played against chord shots. In the video, I have four different rhythms to show you on guitar. The first one will be a single note line part, the others will all be chords, and each one is one bar in length. So let's go and zoom in on the neck and get started. The first single note line idea functions between fourth string and third string. We're gonna start on the fourth string on the fifth fret G, and we're gonna go over to the seventh fret A. We're going to use 16th note feel on this, and the idea will be we'll have a 16th note coming into an 8th that'll sustain, and then we'll have our final 16th of that beat. So it'll be 1 E and A, just like that. Then we have the second beat and the third beat off as rests, and then we head over to the fourth beat where we have a 7th fret D note on 3rd string coming up into a 9th fret E on 3rd string. So that's pretty easy. You know, we'll come into that 2, 3, 4, and then it'll cycle back into that downbeat of 1. So I'm gonna turn the metronome on, and we're just gonna put this into time. Here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 E and a 2, 3, 4, and 1 E and a 2, 3, 4, and. The next example uses a couple of 16th note shots that are gonna take place as power chords built off the fourth string. And we're gonna have a 7th fret A note, then we're gonna go up a 5th to the E, and then we're gonna add on an octave of another A at the 10th fret of the 2nd string. So we have frets 7, 9, and 10 across from 4th to 3rd to 2nd strings. And the shots that we're gonna do are just gonna take place as 16th notes on the downbeat of 1 and the downbeat of 3. So it's gonna be two shots there for the 16ths. It'll be 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4. So just, I'll turn on a metronome and give you a chance to hear what that's like in time. Here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here they are, a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a... The next idea, we'll use an A minor triad up at the 12th position, coming off 3rd string at 14th fret with ring finger, going across to the 13th fret of 2nd string, C note with middle, and then an E note up at 12th fret of 1st string with index. And the shots that we'll be doing will all be on the offbeat of every beat of the measure. So it'll be kind of like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. So in your head, you may want to count 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. I'll turn the metronome on and just give you a bit of an idea of what that sounds like in time. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. The next rhythm idea is in fifth position. We're gonna be doing a bar right across from third to second to first strings. And it's just top three strings of the guitar barred with your index finger. And we'll have a C note to an E to an A, spelling out a small A minor chord there. And what we're gonna do with this rhythm is it's gonna be all continuous 16th note groove stuff, but we're going to have punches in between a whole lot of scratch rhythm playing. So I'm gonna go through this beat by beat with you. The first beat is, the first three 16th notes are all scratches, so we'll have 1E and then on the we'll have the chord coming in. So 1E and Then on the second beat, we're gonna have the first two 16ths be scratches, so it'll be 1E, and then on the and of two, we have our chord shot, but on the we're back to a scratch rhythm. On the third beat, it's all scratch rhythm, 3E and And then on the fourth beat, we're going to have on the downbeat, we'll have our chord coming in. And then the after the fourth downbeat there, everything else is scratch rhythm. So it's like 4E and I'll go through that one more time, just counting it all out for you. Here we go, 3, 4, 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. Now I'll put the metronome on and put it into time, give you a chance to hear what it sounds like. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hopefully this two-part video lesson has given you a chance to understand the wildly rhythmic world of Afrobeat guitar. With a quick search for the term Afrobeat on either YouTube or through Google, you'll find a good deal of bands that you can listen to check this style out a little bit further. So thanks for watching, and thanks for all your questions and messages. I may not answer them all, but I do read them all. And in the weeks ahead, there will be an accompanying article for this lesson over on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. The tabs will, however, be up sooner on my blog site at andrewwasson.com, so check that out. You can follow me on Twitter for lesson material, posting announcements, and until next time, keep jamming out. Take care, everybody, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye for now.